Well, from ATVs, we switch now to UAVs, which is short for Unmanned Aerial Vehicles. And I'll tell you what, not a week goes by where you don't pick up some type of foreign publication and read about them becoming more and more advanced. Love them or hate them, they are the future of agriculture.
Yeah, Ray, judging from the reaction of the people out here, they love them. In fact, they were one of the more popular attractions here at the Expo. Our Mark Wildman attended one of the demonstrations and shows us why UAV technology will be coming to a farm near you sooner rather than later.
As this rotary aircraft takes off, you might easily mistake it for a toy, but it is not. It is one of the latest advancements that might change the way farmers view their crops. Out in the fields, the Georgia Center of Innovation for Aerospace organized an event to highlight these unmanned aerial vehicles. Its director, Steve Justice, works hard to make sure Georgia takes a lead role in developing this new technology.
We've had a five-year plan working with industry, academia, organizations, the federal government, including the FAA, to prepare the way in Georgia for this new market. We've been working with Middle Georgia State College, many companies, Georgia Tech, and today is culmination of those efforts where we're having flight demonstrations of unmanned aircraft systems to show farmers how they can use them in agribusiness.
The FAA gave permission for this event to be held. Not only were rotary vehicles launched, but a fixed-wing aircraft as well. And getting FAA approval to do this is a big step for the industry.
And this is the first time we know of that the FAA has allowed these kinds of vehicles to fly in an environment with lots of people, lots of equipment around. So that shows a real vote of confidence for what we're doing in Georgia and our universities.
Chad Dennis with Middle Georgia State College was on hand to help out with the aerial demonstrations. Middle Georgia State College works closely with the program, and as unmanned aerial systems take off, the college wants to keep up with the growing technology.
Currently, we're developing UAS academic programs. We're hoping to start offering them as early as the fall, but this spring we'll be putting together various types of certificate and possibly even degree programs. We as a college are able to better adjust to what the industry's needs are and help the FAA in their effort to determine how to safely integrate these into the national air system.
One of the private companies that is developing these aircraft is Guided Systems Technologies. This Georgia company's founder is Eric Corbin. He was on hand to answer questions from spectators on the future of this industry.
So we produce a whole family of fully automated unmanned helicopter systems, including the aircraft you see here, which has been fitted with a simple ATV spray rig for experimenting with spray applications, particular precision spot spraying of crops.
Those involved with unmanned aerial systems say agriculture and these aircraft are a perfect match.
You already have precision agriculture with tractors that can drive themselves and GPS and all these different sensors that they have on the ground. Now we're going to add them in the air. And the trick is to integrate this, make the eye in the sky part of the overall system that the farmer uses to monitor his crops and to increase his yields.
This technology is still in the very early stages of development, but as farmers and others see the potential for growing Georgia's agribusiness, it is sure to gain in popularity. Reporting from the Darrell Williams Research Farm, I'm Mark Wildman for the Georgia Farm Monitor.